Hello all, in this video I am going to discuss about the regulation of cholesterol synthesis at the gene level. So during the synthesis of cholesterol, acetyl-CoA is a precursor molecule. From acetyl-CoA, HMG-CoA is formed. From HMG-CoA, mevalonate, then isopentanyl pyrophosphate, valine, enosterol and cholesterol. So conversion of HMG-CoA to mevalonate, here this reaction is mediated by HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. This HMG-CoA reductase enzyme, it is a key enzyme of cholesterol biosynthesis. It can be regulated by the feedback regulation like mevalonate and cholesterol will inhibit HMG-CoA reductase. It can be regulated at the hormonal level, so insulin that promotes the dephosphorylated form of HMG-CoA reductase, and it will help in the cholesterol biosynthesis, while glucagon will inhibit cholesterol biosynthesis by inhibiting HMG-CoA reductase. As we know, HMG-CoA reductase, it is an enzyme, so it is a protein, so it is made up from the DNA. So in our gene, suppose this is our gene is a nucleotide sequence that will form the protein. So here this gene has a promoter region, and at the promoter region steroid response element binding protein. This SREBP protein binds with this promoter region of the gene, and it will help in transcription and translation of the HMG-CoA reductase enzyme. So this SREBP is normally lying at the endoplasmic reticular membrane of the cell. Along with the SREBP, there is a SCAP protein. SCAP is SREBP cleavage activating protein. This SCAP is a cholesterol sensor. That means you can see here it is a cholesterol sensor. So whenever the cholesterol level is very low, in that case this SCAP will bind with the SREBP and it will escort SREBP to the Golgi membrane. Okay, so it will help the movement of SREBP to the Golgi membrane. At the Golgi membrane, proteases will expose the domain, DNA binding domain of SREBP, so that this SREBP will bind with the promoter region of the HMG-CoA reductase gene, and by that it will help in the gene transcription, and HMG-CoA reductase enzyme is synthesized and it will promote the cholesterol synthesis. So when cholesterol level is very low, then at the gene level it will help in the synthesis of HMG-CoA reductase enzyme, and by that cholesterol synthesis is promoted. See the beauty of God, beauty of nature. Now when cholesterol level is enough, then it will induce insic protein. Okay, this insic protein will bind with the SCAP. So when insic bind with the SCAP, then SCAP cannot bind with the SREBP. So SREBP cannot be escorted to the Golgi membrane. So the DNA binding domain is not exposed. So and by that it cannot act on the promoter region of the gene of the HMG-CoA reductase. And so HMG-CoA reductase enzyme is not synthesized, and so that cholesterol synthesis is lower endogenous. So when cholesterol level in our body is high, then cholesterol synthesis is halted. This is the beauty of the God, how at the gene level cholesterol biosynthesis is regulated. You can see here again also. Okay, this SREBP is bound along with the SCAP, right? So when cholesterol level is low, then SCAP escort this SREBP to the Golgi apparatus. In the Golgi apparatus, there will be proteolytic cleavage, so that the domain, DNA binding domain is exposed, and by that SREBP bind with the promoter region of the gene of the HMG-CoA reductase, and it will transcribe and ultimately translate it to the HMG-CoA reductase. And this HMG-CoA reductase enzyme will convert HMG-CoA to mevalonate, and cholesterol synthesis occurs when cholesterol level is low. But whenever the cholesterol level is high, you can see, so when cholesterol level is high, it will stimulate insic protein. Insic protein will bind with the SCAP, and when insic bind with the SCAP, then it will inhibit. So SREBP cannot go to the Golgi apparatus and ultimately cannot start the transcription of the gene. Okay, this is how at the gene level cholesterol biosynthesis is regulated. Thank you for watching. Bye.